very good day to you. This is Abuja Today, the program that lets you in on all the happenings in Nigeria's capital city right here at your digital first Pan-African news network, TOS TV. I am Ruel Panawo. The National Agency for Food and Drug Administration and Control, NAFDAC, is determined to shut down packaged water production facilities that fail the Good Manufacturing Practice, GMP, requirements, as it pledges to partner with various associations in the efforts to sanitize the packaged water section of the economy. Professor Mojisola Adeyeye, the Director General of NAFDAC, revealed this during a virtual stakeholders meeting held on February 19th in Abuja with packaged water producers in Nigeria on the need to sanitize the water industry. She, however, appealed to the 412 producers who participated in the interactive forum to always ensure that the level of compliance with NAFDAC regulatory requirements for which their products were registered are at all times maintained. The FCT Administration Ministerial Task Team on Traffic Management has appealed to the Federal Ministry of Works and Housing to fix the potholes on the ever-busy AYA Kugboyanya stretch of the Abuja Kefi Expressway. Mr. Ikara Atta, chairman of the team, made the appeal on February 21st in Abuja. Mr. Atta observed that the traffic buildup on the ever-busy AYA Kugboyanya to Kefi Road was mostly caused by the potholes, especially the ones around Kugbo slope down to Karoside Bridge. He called on the ministry to prevail on the contractor handling the road expansion work to fix the failed portions on the road in order to ease difficulties faced by motorists. He further explained that traffic personnel of the team from FRSC Directorate of Road Traffic Services Police and the officials of Abuja Environmental Protection Board, APB, were regularly on the route lining up and down to ensure free flow of traffic during busy periods. A Nigerian Air Force intelligent reconnaissance aircraft crashed on February 21st at Nnamdi Azikiwe International Airport, Abuja, killing all seven persons on board. The military aircraft, a King Air B350 plane, crash-landed on the final approach path of Abuja Runway 22 at 10:48 a.m. This happened shortly after the pilot complained of engine failure. The aircraft exploded on impact, triggering a ball of flames. The aircraft reported engine failure at time 10:39 a.m. and crash-landed on the final approach path of Abuja Runway 22 at time 10:48 a.m. According to fire services who arrived at the scene, all seven persons on board died. Internal Revenue Service of the Federal Capital Territory, FCT IRS, has given a March 31 deadline to all taxpayers in FCT to file their annual tax returns. Mr. Abdullahi, the executive chairman of the service, said this during an interview on February 21st in Abuja. He explained that the law required every taxable individual to file a tax return within 90 days after the end of the financial year, and therefore all taxpayers are required and expected to file the tax return between January and March 31st yearly. He appeals to Abuja residents to do their civic responsibility for those who are taxable and showed his excitement as senior officials have begun filing in returns ahead of the March 31st deadline. The FCT Police Command has arrested 9 robbery suspects along Jabi, Utako, Wuse and Kwali axis. The suspects were arrested during different intelligence operations between February 10th to 18th, 2021. The suspects are Ada Johnson, age 20, Ibere Kweme, 19, Freedom Emmanuel, 20, Gambo Alanana, 19, Gideon Adaga, 35, Friday Adamu, 20, Danjuma Gambo, 19, Abubakar Aliyu, 20, and Jude Godwin, 25 years. According to a statement by ASP Maryam Yusuf, FCT police spokesperson, exhibits recovered from the suspects include 3 locally fabricated pistols, 1 unexpended cartridge, 4 cutlasses, 1 cutter, 3 television sets, 4 mobile phones, and 130,000 naira cash. The suspects will be brought to court immediately after investigation. Some public secondary and tertiary health care institutions in Abuja are faced with challenges that affect their quality of service delivery. Findings reveal that these challenges include inadequate manpower, poor electronic medical records, overcrowding, poor emergency services, and attitude of staff, few or no ambulance services, and ineffective national health insurance system. Others include poor infrastructure, insufficient primary health care, long queues and waiting time, poor attitude of staff and miss others. An Abuja resident who identified himself as Umar said he accessed care at the Wuse District Hospital but always faced the challenge of overcrowding and long queues, and due to that challenge he opted for private hospitals when faced with a medical challenge. Mr. Umar has beckoned on the government to employ more medical personnel in public hospitals in Abuja for fast response. Two persons identified as Rabiu Abubakar and Mohammed Dan Kwairo were burnt to death after a tanker exploded at the Yaba Junction of Gadabiyu village on the Abuja Lokoja Road. According to reports, the petrol laden tanker lost control and crashed into a ditch. Some residents rushed to the scene with jerry cans and buckets with intentions to scoop fuel before the tanker exploded, burning two people to death and leaving two injured. When contacted, Ayuba Wobingora, the FCT sector commander of the Federal Road Safety Corps, FRSC, confirmed the tanker explosion, but said he was not aware of the deaths. And that's all we have on Abuja Today right here on your digital First Pan-African News Network, TOS TV. For more updates, visit www.tostvnetwork.com. Do follow and like TOS TV Network on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram, and remember to subscribe on YouTube. Do stay with us and enjoy more programs on TOS TV Network. I am Ruel Panawo. Bye for now.